viewers, welcome to Limu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I'm your tutor, Phyllaris Tirit. Today we are going to look at English from 1 lesson 15. Our topic will be on grammar, and the subtopic we're going to be focused on verbs. And so you can look at our objective. By the end of the lesson, you as a learner should be able to name a verb, identify the different types of verbs, and differentiate between two types of verbs, which is action verbs and the stative verbs. And we'll begin with the definition of verbs, and you can say a verb is a word that tells or asserts something about a person or a thing. A verb tells us the following: what a person or thing does, what is done to a person or a thing, and what a person or a thing is. We have two types of verbs, action verbs and stative verbs. We can begin with action verbs from the word action. This is a verb that tends to show action. It means an action was done or is or was performed. For instance, he washed the car with a piece of cloth. What was the action done in the sentence? Washing. Our class sang the song quickly. The question is, what was done by the class? The class that did the singing. When we talk of stative verbs, these are verbs that tend to tell us about the state or condition of somebody or something. For instance, our English teacher is very good. So what is the condition? The condition or the state is that the teacher is good. Does she feel hungry? The word feel is a verb that tends to tell us about the condition of the person. When we also talk of verbs, in verbs we have two types of tense. And in form one, we're going to look at the present tense and the past tense. The simple present tense and the simple past tense. And we'll begin with defining what is tense. We can say tense shows the time of the action or the time of the state expressed by the verb. In English, we have two tenses, the simple present tense and the simple past tense. We'll begin with the present tense, and you can say simple present tense are used to express habits. Example, Monia gets up when the sun rises and comes when darkness disappears. That is a habit of Monia getting up early when the sun rises, and he comes back when darkness disappears. So the word gets, rises, and darkness are words which are used to express the simple present tense. We can also say another function of simple present tense. They are used to refer to something that always happens without fail. Something that happens without fail. That means it happens every day or on a regular basis. For example, the sun rises and sets every day. The words are used to describe the simple present tense is rises and sets. We also have simple present tense another function. It is used to talk of future events. Example, we must complete the shopping before school starts next week. That's a plan or something that will happen in the future. We must complete the shopping before schools start next week. Then we can look at also simple past tense, and you can say it describes an action performed and completed in the past. Simple past tense. These are tenses that are used to describe actions that were performed in the past. It can be yesterday, early in the morning. It is used to describe something that happened sometimes back and not in the moment. When we talk in the moment, that is when we talk of present tense. But when we talk of the past, we talk of the simple past tense, an action that was done. For example, he lost his pen. The word lost is used to describe an action that happened in the past. That was losing, or the pen got lost. Another one, they left their luggage. Left means the luggage was left there either yesterday or some days ago. Having done that, you can look at the assignment as posted there. Use the verbs in the correct simple tense to fill in the gap in each of the following sentences. We have the question, so it's you, the learner, to answer the questions. And for much and for Much of these you can refer to Exiling in English, Students Book 1 at Kenya Literature Bureau, which is our text. You can also reach to us through the following, our SMS line as posted, YouTube at Elimu TV, Facebook at Elimu TV, or on Twitter at Elimu TV underscore KE. Thank you very much for the lesson.